Chancellors! Welcome back to the official tutorial series for Slime Isekai Memories, Elara's Expedition, in which I, Elara, community representative of Slime Isekai Memories, will take you through the various things and aspects of the game, and I hope this will help beginning but also more advanced players understand the game better. So in a previous topic we went over terminology, and today is time for the second topic, which will cover materials, how to obtain them, gear, and charms. So without further ado, let's get started. So in the first video, we're going over the best ways and locations to gather materials, starting off with magicules. As we said in the terminology video, magicules are needed to level up your characters. You can get magicules from clearing the level up quests, and the most can be obtained from the expert level quest Master 2. And you have to parallel process that, and then you will get lots of magicals. And it is also recommended to use the growth fortune charm and to level it up to max to increase the magicals you gain from doing these quests. If you're ever in urgent need of magicals, you can obtain some from different bazaar shops through the shop window. However, since these quests are always available, we recommend you to parallel process these quests to get these materials. And then we are going to gold. Gold is needed to pay for upgrading your buildings and your gear. You can obtain gold in a similar fashion to the magicals from special quests, the gold coin quest. There's also a charm similar to the magicals that increases the amount of gold you earn, called the gold fortune charm. Also, something else, if you are part of a union, we'll go more into that in another video in the future, you can increase the gold earned from the gold quest by having an active gold coin collecting barrier stone. And the same as magicals, you can get gold from bazaar shops, but the shops often offer lots of valuable items, so make sure to choose your rewards wisely. Then we go to stamina potion. Stamina potions and stamina is needed to take part in battle and events. Make sure to always do your dailies to obtain stamina pots from the daily missions, as you can see here. And when you engage with your characters through the home menu, sometimes some characters will offer you stamina potions from time to time. Another important source of stamina is the hot spring, which you unlock by clearing Story Chapter 11, Part 7. And you can visit it once a day to regain some stamina. You can also obtain stamina pots from some bazaar shops, such as the Event Bazaar of the monthly ongoing event, and some others. But as with the others, choose wisely what you want to exchange your currency for. For more advanced players who have already unlocked Valor Cop and Loop Loop, once you've farmed a lot of these coins, you can also exchange these for stamina pots for a relatively cheap way if you don't aim to get other rewards. Then we have food. Food is needed to increase the bond with your characters, the relationships. And for each bond level you increase, you will receive some magic crystals, so it's a good source of magic crystals if you obtain a new character, and it increases their stats as well. The best way to obtain food is through the special Great Harvest Feast events that get held periodically, and you can parallel process these quests as well. But, as usually, you also get food from different buildings in your town. Note that every character prefers a different food type, so make sure to pay attention to what food effectively increases the bond of that character. You can see that over here. Then we have the ability release materials. The ability release materials, as we've seen in the previous topic video, can be obtained from special dedicated quests separated by the materials for the regular boards and one specifically for the EX board. You have quests for each specific type, from training, defense, to stamina, etc. Something else we also discussed in the previous video was the skill level up materials. The level up materials can be earned by taking part in the daily predator quests. It's very important, they're also part of your dailies, that you clear those every day because they're very helpful. And make sure to choose a specific skill what you need. So for example, if you need an attack increasing skill, you can do that, and etc. Then for the perfect or joker skills, as we mentioned in the previous video as well, you can earn these during an event. So every month there's an event and it comes with a special dedicated predator battle, as you can see here. And clearing that predator battle daily 3 times will give you the special perfect skill enhancement materials. You can also obtain skill level materials in the dedicated bazaar in the shop that you see right now. And you get the currency to trade from taking part in the daily regular predator battle. So in case you need them and you see that you need to level up a specific skill, but you're lacking certain skill enhancement materials, use them then whenever you need them in the predator battle shop. Also, you'll be able to trade some skill level up materials in the event bazaar of that month, as you see here. Then, an important event to take part in anytime it is active is the Kaijin event. Every once in a while, the game will have the Kaijin event, and this is the best time to gather ability release materials, but also gear upgrade materials, which we'll explain a bit more in the gear video in the next topic. And this is how it works. You have these different quests, and by taking part and using, you know, parallel processing, you can get as many rewards as possible. Know that this is the best time, so definitely don't miss it whenever you see it's coming. There are also various other materials which you can obtain by playing the game, but we'll make sure that these get featured in dedicated videos at a later time. In the next video, we're going to focus on the gear and how to obtain the materials needed to improve it. And make sure to follow us as usual on our social media channels. And we'll see you in the next video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a nice day. Bye bye. See you later.